Here's my Insta profile. I have a certain theme going here where the look is very similar, especially in my recent photos. All of these are edited in Photoshop. Today I will try to achieve a similar look on mobile using Snapseed app. So here's the image I snapped imported into Snapseed. First, I'll try to remove this tower using healing tool. As you can see, when it comes around the edges, the results are not so good. I'm gonna try another method. Using double exposure, I'm gonna add the same image and move it a bit so that the sky is over the tower. Now, setting the opacity to 100 and going to masking screen. Here, with the original image hidden and brush value at 100, brushing on the tower to remove it. I'll keep the edges as it is. We'll fix this with the healing tool. Doing rough healing here to get rid of the top part. Limitations of Snapseed here. Now, adding few selective filters in the sky to make the area completely bright. Trying to make the sky as white as possible. There's still some blue left here. Adding another one. This contrast has affected the foreground too. Going to masking screen and removing it. Now is the step to add the mountains. Before starting this edit, I edited the image a little to make it easier to add it here. Use selective filters to make the top surroundings completely white. Also the mountains a little less contrasty. Using curves, added some haze effect which could come useful. Also made the image completely white and brushed on the mountain edges to remove these clouds, especially the ones closer to the mountains. And saved it. Now adding the saved image using double exposure and choosing darken mode, which adds the image mainly on the brightest parts. Moving it to a suitable position. Going to masking screen and first adding the mountains from the bottom so that the clouds in the sky do not end up here. Also with the brush opacity at 25, brushing around the bottom part of the mountains to give an illusion that it is further from the foreground. Then making sure to remove whatever remains of the image in the foreground. Forgot something, going back to the healing tool and removing this small concrete thing on the left. Worked well here. Now, using double exposure again, adding the image of this evening sky and choosing darken mode again, which works best here. Moving it up a little so that the orangish part of the sky comes around the right edge. You can also see the red shade taking effect on the mountains too. Masking work again to remove the residue of the sky image in the foreground. Next, I'm gonna add an interesting effect using the same sky image. I will leave it at default mode with 50% transparency. Now in the masking screen, just brushing on the edge of the mountain to get this light hazy effect. Looks really nice. Select two filters now, one on the mountain to make the top left part of the mountain more dark. Now using curves, I'm gonna lift the blacks a lot to get this effect. Also adding yellow by dragging the blue curve down. Now in the masking screen, applying it only on the right edge to create the main light source. Using similar effect with a little less intensity. Applying this around the same location. Now adding structure in the details menu. This I will be applying only on the rail tracks and the gravel to get some pop there. We'll create a bit of vignette effect by darkening the overall image using curves. Then in masking screen, zooming out and removing the effect around the light source. Next, some overall tuning in Tune Image menu, adding contrast, saturation, reducing shadows, brightening the highlights. Some masking work on the light source. Going back to make some corrections to fine-tune the brightness around the light source. We'll add more haze around to get a nice effect between the foreground and the background using curves, lifting blacks and adding yellowish tones. Masking screen. Roughly applying around the middle part, then removing it around to fine-tune the selection. A really nice haze effect there. After this, we'll add some finishing touches by exporting this to the free Lightroom app. Here in the light menu, adding whites and reducing blacks to pop the image more. Going to the HSL sliders, moving the green hues towards aqua, also the blues in the sky towards aqua. More orangish tones to the highlights in the color grading tool, adding overall vibrance for a colorful image. We'll reduce the saturation of the yellows here a bit, which seems too intense. Also adding selective sharpening in detail menu. Finally, tuning overall contrast in curves. The final result here. Hope you found the video helpful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.